General quarters, general quarters. All hands, man your battle stations. Operate all crew served weapons. The target is an aircraft bearing 030, heading relative of the rested starboard bow.
Hull 16 and Hull 17, this is Hull 15. Maintain defensive posture. Pilot on the target.
Unknown aircraft at position Delta 4 Bravo, heading southwest at 110 knots. This is Philippine Navy Warship 15 at Bravo 2 Zulu, requesting immediate ident, including call sign, aircraft type, airport of destination, and airport of departure. Again, please ident.
Mayday, 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 Warship 15 over. This is Republic of China Navy Aircraft Registration Kilo Romeo 13 Tango, Romeo Charlie from the ROC Warship Huiyang FFG 937. Aircraft type MDH 500 Helicopter. International Reporting Authentication Code, Kilo Romeo 7229A Lima. Requesting immediate landing. Emergency fuel and heavy damage.
Roger, all copied. Tango Romeo Charlie, proceed south and match heading with the lead ship in the formation. Hull number 15, landing speed 4 knots, set altimeter 2996.
Tango Charlie Romeo, affirm. Proceed south. Match formation with Hull 15. Approach speed 4 knots and altimeter 2996.
Tango Romeo Charlie, this is Hull 15, reported inside of the starboard bow, trailing smoke.
Hull 15 inside, trailing smoke, yes.
Tango Romeo Charlie, how did the damage occur, over?
Tango Charlie Romeo, Hull 15, PRC attack on fleet. Repeat. Chinese attack.
Tango Romeo Charlie, all copied.
Good evening. Welcome to a PNN TV3 special report. I'm Reginald Adiwa. Tonight, a developing story in the seas of Southeast Asia. A statement by a spokesperson of the Philippine Navy and the head of the U.S. Navy Indo-Pacific Command, Admiral Nate Canterbury, said a helicopter and six of her crew from the Taiwanese Navy was shot down near a fleet of Philippine warships. It attempted to make an emergency landing on the BRP Andres Bonifacio after being severely damaged by a Chinese vessel. According to eyewitnesses, the missiles were unlike anything they'd ever seen before. This comes at a time of great tension in the archipelago, after it was revealed that Chinese vessels have rolled out the new Type 70 seaborne missile. Admiral Canterbury advised the public to avoid panic. He promised that as the Philippines' top ally, that the U.S. Navy will do everything in its power to ensure the security of the region. However, Canterbury also relayed a stern message to Beijing, saying that it should act carefully and with diligence to prevent further tragedies. In response, Chinese foreign spokesperson Yi Xianwei said that China's central command was not informed of the incident. Yi added that no official orders were given or handed out by anyone in either the civilian or military chain of command. The People's Republic Foreign Ministry will speak later tomorrow morning after a preliminary investigation. The Chinese government has not officially commented yet, but we'll be back with you when they do. Stay tuned to Channel 3 for more on this special breaking coverage. From Channel 3 TV HQ in Mandaluyong City, I'm Reginald Adiwa.
Yeah, he's catching him as he's coming in.
And there's a left hand that splits the door.
He's hurt, Josh. Very hurt. That straight left hurt.
Maghintay po para sa mahalagang impormasyon mula sa pamahalaan ng Pilipinas. Ang impormasyon na ito ay mahalaga sa iyong kaligtasan at kalusugan. Ang mensahe na ito ay isang emergency warning mula sa pamahalaan ng Pilipinas. Ang mensahe ito ay nagpalit sa nakaraang mensahe kanina. Konfirmado ngayon na ang armada na malapit sa lalawigan ng Batanes ay galing sa China. Sa ngayon, ang lahat ng mga probinsya sa Luzon ay nasa Alert Level 1. Kung kayo ay nasa Luzon, humanda ng pagkain, tubig, gamot, at mga ibang mahalagang bagay para sa 2 linggo. Agad maghanda na tumakas. Nagpatayo ang NDRRMC at AFP ng mga pampublikong shelter kung wala kayong mapupuntahan. Mahahanap ang listahan at lokasyon nito sa kanilang website www.ndrrmc.gov.ph/shelters. Kung kayo ay malapit sa dagat, maghanda na rin ipaglaban ang iyong mga komunidad sa padating na mga sundalo ng China. Gumamit ng anuman mga armas katulad ng baril, kutsilyo, o pampukpok. Pwede rin gumamit ng bote ng alak na may apoy para gumawa ng bomba. Ang pinakamaagang dating ng mga sundalo ay 3 oras. Mag-aanunsyo ng Pangulo ang deklarasyon ng digmaan sa pagdating na oras. Manatiling nakatutok sa balita, radio, telebisyon, o sa internet para sa pinakabagong impormasyon. Sa oras na ito, ipapalabas ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas para natin ihanda ang ating sarili na ipaglaban ang ating mahal na bayan.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.